We made it, Adam.
We did.
We're here with you.
Yes.
So let's tell everyone who you are and what is this beauty in front of us.
So my name is Adam Holloway, Everyman Overland on Instagram. And what we have here is my 2018 Chevy Colorado ZR2.
Behind the scenes.
It almost looks like it's matte now on the middle part.
We'll leave it like that.
Beautiful color. You've had it for how long?
I got it in March of 2018, so I've had it for just over three years.
And you've done some work to it. I mean, this is definitely not stock ride height, I don't think, right?
So the ride height is not stock, but all of the under suspension is still factory GM suspension, yeah. So it just, it's got a phony lift. It's got an inch and a half body lift on there.
Yeah.
So I wanted to keep the stock DSSV shocks from Chevrolet. So that was the reason why.
Okay, I have to ask, are those shocks everything they're cracked up to be? Like everything that they've made them out to be in the you know, media marketing?
Well, you know, everybody says kings and fox and this.
Yeah,
and that.
That's what I'm at. Great question.
I love the shocks from the day I got the truck. From the day I drove it off a lot, from the first time it hit the dirt, they actually really start to come alive the faster you go with the shocks. Yeah.
So. Yeah. I mean, I had to ask because obviously you kept them, and yeah. And knowing you as long as I have, I know that you do everything very deliberately, right?
Yes. So. It's been put together, you know, purposely. Why it is the way it is.
Totally.
Tried to keep it as stock as possible. Try to, you know, mostly for the everyday Joe who can go out. Pick one of these up off a lot and really not do much to it.
Yeah.
And be able to go out and have fun, get to places that you're not going to get in a standard four-wheel drive. The nice thing about the ZR2 is it comes factory with front and rear locking differentials.
Right, right.
The
That's huge.
Factory rock sliders. It really comes well equipped from GM. It's a really good, capable vehicle.
You've got something new on the front and something that really kind of just... in my opinion, kind of steals the show a little bit. Like, these things are nuts.
Yeah, the new Flex 4 Eras from KC are pretty amazing lights. I've had them on for about 2 weeks now. Took them up to Mojave 2 weeks ago, and we ran them in the dark, all five of them running without any amber lenses, and they are just phenomenal lights. I know the guy who runs Midwest Overland, and he actually made that bar for me special because it normally comes with four tabs, and I have to be different, so I asked for five tabs so we could put five lights up in front. It used to have five of the dual flexes in amber.
Right, but I do remember that, yeah.
When the Era 4s came out, I thought, okay, you know, let's step it up a little bit. And we'll put the light of the sun up on the front of the
yeah.
truck. So,
and that's funny because before you even had these, we used to say that about having the Gravity Pro 6s on the roof.
Yes.
About how it was literally like having the sun at your fingertips.
Yep.
And I gotta say, since seeing these, that's definitely changed my mind a little bit about how. But these things are ridiculous.
They are. They are. I just can't say enough. Just the little time that I've had them, they are phenomenal lights. I don't even have the words to explain how incredible they are. I run them in a spread pattern, spot pattern, spread, spot, spread.
Okay, so you're kind of going every other.
Yeah, so I get good dispersion, and then I get some distance down the middle of the road. So when you get on some of the high-speed stuff, we're not doing
totally.
120
right.
in Baja.
We're not doing trophy truck stuff.
But when you get out there, sometimes you want to go a little faster at night. And when you're doing 50, 60 down a dirt road, you want to be able to see what's coming up.
Yeah.
These lights will definitely give you the capability to see what's coming up, you know, a half mile, you know, a kilometer down
and
the road.
And sometimes it's just a matter of just seeing wildlife.
Yes.
Right? Like
yeah.
That's a huge one, right?
It's
not always seeing that the road's going to turn or whatnot. Like, that's a big reason some of the decisions that I know a lot of guys have made is just being able to see wildlife. Way before it decides to dart in front of you.
Yeah, at nighttime when you're looking for the little shine of the eyes on the side of the road, because you know those animals can dart out in front of you in a blink of an eye. So WOR is a partnership that myself and three other friends have: John, Matt, and Cody Weekend Off-Road, and we take local first-time off-roaders or new to the off-road, and we take them out to the local areas, Anne's Borrego, Big Bear, Monachi Meadows, places like that. We do small overlanding, off-roading, camping trips. People who are new to the scene, they want to kind of get into the scene.
So this is taking them from the shallows into the wastewater.
The people who've gone and they bought a truck that has a 4WD button, but they don't know what the 4WD button does.
Right.
So we want to get them out, hit that button, and show them what their vehicles are capable of.
And AWD as well?
Yes, yes. The vehicles, the paths we take, all-wheel drives will be just fine. Sprinter vans, full-size vehicles.
Oh, you guys have had a few of those. That's right. I remember that. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. We've got our buddy Brian who brings his sprinter van out. And
He's become like the leader of the sprinter army, hasn't he?
Yeah, they're actually up in Big Bear this
I
weekend.
I saw that.
Or Death Valley. Death Valley
with our buddy from Ground Pounder Coffee.
Yes, yeah, exactly.
Jim.
Exactly, yep. Jim from Ground Pounder came out from Vegas and he's supplying them with
I saw one of his percolators going on Instagram, and I was like, oh, that coffee looks so good.
Yeah, yeah. His morning pour-overs are the best.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So these are built into the rack, right? Like they're inset, they're very clean.
So they're integrated.
Yeah.
It's separate from the rack, but it's integrated into there. They're cut out specifically for the C4, the 5-unit C4 light. So it when you come to camp at night and you pull in, you know, after you've been on the trail for 9, 10, 11 hours,
yeah,
and it's dark and you want to set up and you can hit the button and you can light up 360 degrees around your vehicle to set up and feel safe, and you can see what's out there. You know, the scene lights on this, those C4 lights, they are fantastic.
That's awesome. And the AMRAC too, right? It gives you additional options for storage up top.
Yep. I don't have anything up there right now. That's going to be getting some solar panels and probably some traction boards.
Oh, nice.
For a longer trip we've got coming up in June this year.
Should we go down before we get too far back? I think we're already here and we've got some good lighting. So let's talk about what we got going on over here.
So I've got the VTX Rogue wheels, and they're wrapped with the new 34 1050 BFG KO2s. One of the things that I have done with my suspension though is Peak Suspension has done a coilover kit, and they have put a new spring and new coilover, so I've got a little bit of adjustable compression for the shock so that I can actually adjust the ride height on this without having to do anything with leveling pucks or anything like that. So there's nothing added to the suspension, just the Peak coils and the coilover sleeves that actually give me that adjustability. And it's sitting about an inch and a quarter higher in the front than a stock would on top of the lift.
Got it. Very cool. And you do you still do the work for with BFG?
Yep. So I'm one of the radio relays for BF Goodrich, otherwise known as Relay 21, when I'm down in Baja, when I'm lucky enough to go down and support the BFG team and the BFG racers.
Yeah. And so for those that don't know, like some of what you just said, because that's very specific, like I guess you said you'd have to be in it to know exactly what you just said, but you're doing radio communications for some major races that are going on in Baja.
Yep. So we do we do all of the score races down in Baja.
Okay.
There typically is somebody from the BFG relay team down there. The bigger races require more relay operators. We could have 1, 2, 3, 7. So this year's 1,000, I believe, is going to be point to point.
Okay.
So we're going to have relay operators that are going all the way down.
Oh, so it's not going to be 900
miles.
No. Wow. That's cool.
I believe it's every 3 years they go point to point.
Oh, wow.
This year's the big race.
Yeah, that's a big one. Yeah. Nice. And I think we talked to Olaf earlier, and he does that with you as well, right?
Yep. He comes up with me. It's nice to have extra people, because some of the longer races, the 1000 and the 500, we have to be on the air from start to finish
during the entire race.
If it's a loop race, we could be on the air, if you're depending on where you are, for up to 36 hours.
Okay, so you guys pull shifts at that point.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So you're the comms guy. No wonder you were here helping Ali.
Yes. It's funny because that's kind of the moniker that I get usually when we're out too, is everybody will bring their radios to me and go, I can't hear anything.
I know I did.
Yeah.
I know. So quick, interesting kind of like story is I met Adam also through the Rig for Dirt meetup, same way I met Olaf, probably about 3 or 4 years ago, longer than that, probably 4 or 5 years ago.
I met you at your Shimano meetup in the parking lot.
Oh, yeah, that was going back.
When you still had the Ford.
It's right, when I still had the... Yeah. Ah, that's going back. Yeah. Okay, so that's easily 4 years that since that you and I have known each other. And Adam is our kind of comms expert, and he's done... You've done radio classes for us at the Rig for Dirt meetups regarding ham radios, frequencies, how to use them, how to... What classes to take and how to pass a test.
Yep.
How to communicate within, you know, your mobile caravan, your party, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. So we go over repeater operations, the basics of 2 meter and 70 centimeter, UHF, VHF.
Right.
And the one thing we always push is we want people to get their license.
Absolutely.
I know Ollie was talking about it earlier, but you know, you get so much more functionality out of your 2 meter and 70 centimeter radio. Yeah. When you have your license, you get APRS functionality, which is
huge.
A beaconing function that most people don't even realize that you get.
Yeah, most people don't realize that your ham system can function as GPS system.
Yep.
Right? And that's huge.
Yeah. Yeah. So you need a special radio. I have one in my vehicle that actually has the GPS, but it does have the ability to set your location, and somebody can look you up on the internet if they know what the call sign is and just find out what your location is.
And if you really want to geek out on this, am I correct? I remember I had a buddy in Orange County near where I live who told me that you can send data over ham radio networks if you know what you're doing.
So you can send text messages with APRS.
Oh, with APRS?
Yeah, so you can send direct text messages with APRS.
So if you really want to dive down the rabbit hole, there's some cool stuff that you can do if you get a license.
Yeah, yeah. So simplex radio to radio, which we normally use, and then you know, you're talking anywhere from 20 to 50 miles, and depending on the power, the wattage. If you get to the license and get to that repeater function, you know, you're going hundreds of miles
with
the repeater.
You can go global. Yeah, I've talked to people on the Wind system all over the world.
Yep. Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely.
For sure.
All right, back of the house. There's a lot going on back here, more than it looks. Like, I'm just looking and I can peek through the rack, so I can see there's a lot going on back here. So we'll start with the rack system and what's on that.
So this is the, I was fortunate enough when I got the truck, there wasn't a lot of support for the ZR2 Colorado.
Yeah.
I got a lot of support from manufacturers, whether it would be KC, or in this instance, it was Cali Raised.
Okay.
This is their overland bed rack that they used my truck actually to prototype this rack. This is number one for the Colorados.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so this is the...
Super early.
I had a special request when I was doing my truck, is I wanted everything to be low.
Yeah.
So I wanted the roof line to stay kind of sleek, you know, try to maintain some of the gas mileage and, you know, reduce some of that overhead weight and center of gravity. So there's a reason why this is this way. They actually do offer this height now.
Oh, wow.
So this is their overland low bed rack.
Yeah, I've noticed a lot of companies have since added that to their repertoire or their offering, where they have this kind of low profile rack, and they'll have a higher rack for those that really want to load up. But this seems to be a pretty popular size where they want to keep it in line with their roof line and just not have any further obstructions kind of catching air.
Yep, exactly. Now, another one of our friends we've had been fortunate enough to know is Nick Mazzanti with Rome Adventure Co.
Yeah.
So this is the Vagabond Light tent, which was perfect for me. I was a, I stayed away from the rooftop tent for a long time.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
I was a ground tent guy.
Totally, yeah.
You know, I 100%. Did other things. But when this tent, when Nick talked about this tent, it kind of fit right into what I wanted.
Yeah.
Something relatively small. It's perfect for two people. It goes up relatively easy. This doesn't have the overhang. It doesn't have an annex. It's very fast to go up, very fast to go down. So it fit right perfect for me. 99% of the time, I'm always by myself when I'm out traveling, or when I'm with people, I'm in the rig alone, so I'm only in the car by myself.
Yeah.
So I don't need a big, you know.
Yeah, you're not hauling a family. You're not hauling a bunch of kids or anybody else.
No. Nope.
Yeah.
So
exactly.
I've got my one bedroom condo up there.
Nice.
It fits just perfect for me. So, and it works out really great. And it's super comfortable. Once you get it out and get on that foam pad, it's very nice.
Lights out.
Yep. Okay. And obviously the antennas,
right?
You're dual on both sides, because depending on the event, sometimes I'll have to run dual radios. Here's my $12 platform that holds my fridge, my 60% seat delete. There's my first aid kit, IFAC, my HT radio up there, so when you got to bail out and spot for somebody.
That's fantastic.
So that's
a good spot to actually have your kit. We talked about this in the podcast, actually, about having your kit where you can reach it.
Yeah, and that's a quick breakaway HIFAC, so you just grab it and pull it, and it comes off of that Molly. That's a 511 Molly backseat panel. So, yeah.
Very cool. Right on. Well, Adam, thanks a lot, man. It's been awesome.
Thanks, Frank.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate. Yep.
Paparazzi, whatever perception you have of me, starting with the truth, starting with what everyone's thinking, start there, put some dope with it.